Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. The book we are talking about today is called Sapiens, A Brief History of Humankind. This book is written by Yuval Noah Harari. He has a PhD from Oxford University and is currently a teaching professor in Hebrew University of Jerusalem. This book was a long read because this book has everything. When I say everything, I actually mean everything. Agricultural revolution, hunter-gatherers, foragers, cognitive revolution, French revolution, industrial revolution, technological revolution, religion, psychology, biology, chemistry, fall and rise of empires and rise of capitalism, communism and more. So when I say it's a long read, I mean it's a long read. Since this is a non-fiction, there is no story as such for me to give a gist. So I'll just be talking about points that I thought were interesting. I won't lie, when I first started reading the book, I was a little uncomfortable reading it because I thought it was cynical and depressing. But then I decided to keep an open mind and I continued reading it. And there are so many interesting things to learn from this book that I recommend everybody to read this book once in their lifetime. It is provocative. It makes you think. The former president of United States, Barack Obama, has actually said that this book is provocative. So if a book makes you think, that means it's actually a good book. And please start reading this book only if you have the time to give. And because after you finish a chapter or two, you just have to sit and think about what you've read. It's definitely not a bedtime read. This book tickles the most important question of human history. That is, what are we and how did we get here? So if you're curious to know why things are the way they are today, you definitely have to read this book. Harari says that the history we know about humankind is a very small part of the history of humankind. We kind of realize that there is so much more that has happened with our ancestors that we probably don't know about. The best thing about this book is Harari's writing. It's very engaging and entertaining, and also it's in layman's terms. You need not be a history scholar to understand this book. And sometimes I felt like this book was fiction and non-fiction because of the way he's written. He has explained concepts through stories by giving a lot of examples. And there were so many concepts that I didn't understand back in school or college, but I understood it while reading this book. Harari not only talks about our history, he also talks a lot about our present and possible future. And that is what makes this book more interesting. One more chapter or point that hit me hard was the concept of happiness that he's described. Harari argues that we still don't know what makes people happy. We have been through so much since history, since rise and fall of empires. We have been through so many revolutions and people are still in search of happiness. Even scientists, biologists, psychologists and religious scholars are trying to find an answer for what happiness means to people. But we still don't have an answer for it and we still don't know what makes people happy. Is it money or is it power or health? We still don't know. Do you really know what makes you happy? He ends this book with a very interesting question. What do you want to want? Spooky, isn't it? So to know what he means by this question, you definitely have to read this book. I highly recommend reading this book. And while reading this book, please keep an open mind because it kind of probably it might trigger you. But you have to read it. Yeah. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more such videos, like, share and subscribe to our channel.